So welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm so glad we can spend this time virtually doing this in a time that we're so socially disconnected this year. But yes, dogs are always welcome. Cats are welcome in this practice. If your dog or cat come into the room, no big deal. But finding this time for you, this space to kind of take a break from whatever's going on in your life. We're not necessarily trying to push it away, but we're just taking, as I like to say, kind of a pause and a reset for yourself. So let this time really be for you to find that for you, for your mind, your body, and your heart. So let's go ahead and find your seat. We're gonna start, if it doesn't feel comfortable to lay on your back, then you don't have to. You can start seated. A pillow or a bolster is always very welcome for this part of the practice, but we're going to take our blocks in kind of an upside down T. And if you need to find the lower height, you can find the lower height. But I'm going to, excuse me, take my forearms beside that first one to kind of lay my shoulder blades down on that. And then I'm going to lay my head so my whole neck is supported on that upper one. Now, a bolster or a pillow could also offer the same support, or if laying flat feels better, do so. And it may feel good. I know sometimes I like to just come into this and reach my arms overhead, just getting a little bit of a gentle kind of opening across the chest, heart space, the spine. But then I like to lay my arms down so that the arms are lower than the shoulders, elbows bent. And you can start with your feet flat like I'm doing. You could open up soles of the feet, Baddha Konasana, knees opening out. Certainly also lay those legs out. Corpse pose, whatever kind of feels best for you this morning, I want you to find that. What I like to say is you really take care of you on this mat. I will do my best to take care of you. It's a little harder doing this virtually. I will offer cues and little reminders for you to just do you today. So if that means dropping into child's pose or finding a modification, I want you to do that. Let's just take a couple of rattle breaths. Deep breath in through the nose. Big sigh out through the mouth. Twice more like that breath. In, fill up. Empty out. And one more. As you breathe in, I want you to maybe focus, or not focus on, but just bring to mind something that you can just let go of right now that may be occupying your mind, your heart, your shoulders. Really allow that exhale to soften. Let be from that thought, that experience. And then just start to land here. I want you to feel those contact points to the earth. Maybe your feet. The backs of your hands. Your arm, your elbow. Your bum touching the earth. Maybe your back, whatever is touching your prop or directly touching the mat, which is then essentially touching the earth beneath you. I want you to feel those contact points. This earth has this amazing, nurturing, supportive energy. Allow yourself to be supported right here. And the earth can also kind of be absorb or take on any energy right now, anything that you can just release from those contact points as if they're roots rooting down. Allow the earth to take whatever that may be and compost it.
use that energy to bring light back into your body, positivity, strength, compassion, love. Envision the cycle of energy dropping down into the earth, and then she in return allows whatever it is that you can offer to yourself back up into your space. The exhale allows you to drop down, release, and the inhale is again that offering. Might feel this opening across your heart space, your chest. Feel that lifting, that expansion. Maybe even that image of receiving. It's within your practice right now, you can start to find and cultivate a little deeper breath, ujjayi breath, breathing in and out through the nose. But if letting that breath move out through the mouth still feels good to the body, then do that. Take five more breaths here for yourself. Each exhale you take, just parking one more breath, one more moment, landing a little bit more further into the here and now. Take a collective breath in, breathe in. Breathe out together. Beautiful. If your legs are extended or in Baddha Konasana, bring the soles of your feet flat. Your forearms in close beside your body. Start to press into your forearms to lift your head, just gently lifting. Taking a moment, just kind of acclimate here. You need to turn the head a little bit side to side. And then you're gonna lift off of your blocks. If you were using blocks, place them off to the side. We're gonna come back to them in just a few. If you don't have a block, once again, don't sweat it. And then just come all the way to your back. Draw the knees into the chest. And just make some circles one direction and then the other. Massaging out the lower back. Just begin to notice any sensations. And then the knees just come center. Take a moment here. Just gently press into the shin bones down into the earth. We need to take those knees a little wider. Do so. And then you can let the knees just gently drop to one side. Doesn't matter which side. If it feels better to bring the knees further up or maybe even further down so you get a little deeper into a hip flexor stretch, then do so. Just letting the arms open up might feel good. Taking a breath in here together, taking a breath out. Letting that opposite shoulder root down. And then those knees are just going to come up through center and you'll find your way to the opposite side. Those knees. once again, maybe more of a hip flexor stretch, knees down, maybe more into the back if the knees are closer up to the chest. Anchoring down through that opposite shoulder. Maybe even taking a little bit of a gaze over that opposite shoulder. Now with your next inhale, just arrive back to center. If it feels good, just drop those knees a little side to side, windshield wiper. And then pressing into the earth, the feet to the earth, kind of tilt the pelvis, lift the hips, and place them down. Just kind of resets that lower back. And you're just going to bring those knees back into the chest and extend your left leg out across the mat. Now, if you have a prop, a block, then you are going to use that right now. But if you don't sweat it. You can still do this without. You're going to place your block with that the long side to your thigh, and then your right elbow. So I'm doing my right side. My right elbow is going to press to that thigh. And then I'm going to take my left arm overhead. Just bend your left knee and lift your left foot to the sky for. I want you to start to resist into your block and let your thigh resist into your, resist in with your arm to your block and then the other side, the thigh into the block. A little slow there with the movement. All right, so start to find some contraction, lower belly pulling in. Take your breath in, left arm reaches overhead and you're gonna reach up towards your foot, tap the toes and then lower the arm down. Exhale, tap up. And this time, if it's successful, you extend that left leg out maybe a little bit or all the way to the back. And then exhale, lift up, tap. Inhale, extend away. Now you can certainly keep the head down if your neck doesn't feel good to lift. Breathing in, reach down. I want you to, when you extend that leg out, be mindful of what's going on with your lower back. So although we're not completely crunching that lower back into the earth, there'll be a little bit of an arch. Make sure there's no tension. If you're lifting the shoulders, working the shoulder blades off the earth, contracting here on the exhale. Once again, if this doesn't feel good to your body, you can certainly just drawing the knees in, extend out, find cat-cow, anything that works for you, just to start to waken up the spine, waken up that knee. Run some energy. Keep moving, hang in there. Breath in, breath out. It won't be forever, I promise. Lower belly pulling in. Leg could be just a little movement. For four. Awesome work. For three. Two. And one. Lower that left foot down, release the arm, release your block for a moment, both feet to the earth. Just notice left side to right, kind of that heat building maybe, and just gently let those knees drop. Extend the right leg out, lengthening across that hip flexor. And give that left knee a little squeeze in. Rock. And then setting up for that opposite side, whether you are just kind of using your elbow against the leg or block or maybe even a pillow. You want to start first, just the right leg lifts to the sky. Feel the lower belly pull in and contract, draw the muscles around the ribs down to the earth, lift up, tap the toes, and extend away. So I want you to find that resistance against the block. Moving in towards that center. Now maybe you add that leg out. And then exhale, curl up. Head could stay down. Breath in, breath out. Once again, it could be small movement. Doesn't have to be big. You do you this morning. Awesome work, stay with it. So good. And I'm building some heat for sure. So close. Four more. Stay with it. Always breathe out through the mouth if you need to. Two. Oh, last one. Beautiful. Release down. Place your block beside you so that you have access to it in a few. Take those arms, reach them overhead, pump up the belly, pump up the chest, stretch the leg long, point the toes. And then draw the knees into the chest, hold on to those hamstrings. And just, if it feels good for you, some rocks and rolls upright. You can always go to one side. When you get to the top, pause. Shin bones parallel to the earth. Just hold on to your hamstrings for a moment. Lift out of the lower back. You can always be right here. Now, if you have that block, place it between your inner thighs. Otherwise, squeeze those thighs in. Palms can stay lifted to the sky or hold on to those hamstrings or hands behind us. But little squeezes in for 8, 7, 6, 5. Lifting out of the lower back. 4, 3, 2, 1, place the feet down. Place those blocks at the top of your mat. Soles of those feet together, baddha konasana here. So this should feel nice opening across the psoas, hip flexors, inner thighs, lifting those knees out and then spinning the thighs out and down, really lifting out of the lower back. And then maybe a little bit of a hinging forward here. Lengthen your neck, chin into chest. Shoulders down back. And then inhale back up. Your feet are gonna come flat, hands to those shin bones. Little cat-cow variation here. So lift up, draw the shoulders back, lift through the collarbone, breath in. And then as you exhale, chin to chest, dropping back, feeling the stretch across your shoulder blades. And do this a couple more times, inhale. Exhale. Good. One more. And then inhale back up, cross those ankles, and then land into table pose for a moment. Just realized I don't think I muted all of you. There we go. As much as I love to hear your voice, we don't want some echo. All right, so in table pose, hands underneath those shoulders, knees underneath hips, spread those fingertips, just drop those hips a little side to side, you can kind of look over the shoulder, it feels nice. Across the hip, side of the ribs. And then land back into your table pose. Really spread those fingertips, knees underneath hips. Notice if you are slightly dropping in the shoulders, without rounding, really energize those arms, lifting up and out. Start to feel your lower belly pull in, and you can even take your hand to your lower belly and just contract in and down, like activating Uddiyana Bandha, pulling belly in and down. And then from here, you're gonna just step your right foot back and kind of lift your right knee and foot off the earth. And we're just gonna do some circles. Little hip circles to, with that right leg lifting up. Counterclockwise here. Now notice if you're dumping into that left shoulder, left hip, really try to lift out of that hip. A couple more. Move with your breath this next time. Inhale, kind of lift out to a little fire hydrant. Let that knee pull you a little bit more so you are more centered. Take the left fingertips out to the side. So just kind of mirroring, you're gonna be like this into a cup, cupping the earth. And then if it's accessible for you, start to lift that left arm. So the left arm's pulling to the left, right knee is pulling to the right. Lift out of the center, hold yourself in the center, maybe kick that right leg out for 3. Holding here for 2. And 1. Place the foot down. Toes are pointing towards the front of your mat, spinning that outer edge of that foot down. We're going to take a little half dog here, working an inner thigh stretch. So you can certainly just come down here to forearms. But if it feels okay for you, start to walk those hands forward. Keep the hips over the knees or the hip over the left knee. And then just let your chest drop between the arms. Let the chest melt to the earth. Feel some opening across the underarm, the upper back. Breathe in, breathe out. And this is a good time too, forehead to the earth. Just a little reminder to kind of let go, release from any thoughts that are taking you away from being right here, right now. Kind of massaging the forehead. And then with your next inhale, no rush. Lift hands, one hand and the other, back up underneath the shoulders. Extend your right leg back and then over, cross it over to that left side of your mat. Kind of lean back into that heel, getting a little bit of a stretch here across that right band of your leg. Breathe in, breathe out. More breaths. And then off of that foot, right knee lands to the earth. One cat dog here, inhale, open across the chest. Exhale, press into the earth, round chin to chest. And with your next breath, just land back into that neutral spine. Take a full breath in together. And full breath out. Lifting out of the shoulders, lifting out of the hips. Find that balance to lift your left foot to the sky. And then working some counterclockwise hip circles here, leading kind of with that knee, as if you're painting some circles here. Once again, notice if that right hip is leaning to your right. See if you can bring it a little bit more to center. A couple more like this. Lifting out of the shoulders. Neck stays long. Next time, the left knee opens to the side, a little fire hydrant pause. Taking those right fingertips out to the side for a little extra balance. Stay right here with those hands down, or maybe extend that arm out. Now, can you feel that energy pulling you to the right, to the left? And then down into the earth, so lift up, but find that center, your balance. Maybe extend that left leg out for three, for two, for one. And then place that left leg out, down to the earth. Working into that half dog with the leg extended to the side, really pressing through the outer to the left foot. Forehead maybe comes down to the earth or a block. We're using the forearms. Taking those arms a little wider if your shoulders need some more opening. A little bit of a tilt of the pelvis. Breathe in, breathe out, and maybe a little rock of that forehead side to side, third eye. Emptying out. Using that exhale. Your next inhale, walk one hand and the other, rise up. And then step the left toes off your mat to the right, or towards that right side. I'm a little more off my mat here. I'm gonna lean back into that heel, getting the Achilles stretch, and then also cross both bands, outer bands of those legs. Breath in, breath out. Beautiful job. And then your next breath, no rush, knee to the earth. Next two, the other one, maybe a little hip sway side to side, or if it feels good, a cat dog. And then inhale back, hands underneath shoulders, really spread those fingertips. Make up some space here on the mat. Tilt the pelvis. And then pressing back, a little softened knees into your first downward dog. Pedaling one foot and then the other, letting the knee bend, really reaching that opposite heel to the mat, getting that nice stretch. And you might just notice, left side feels a little tighter than right. Notice, no forcing, no rejecting, so to speak, or judging. And then I want you to just kind of land in the center here, a little soft bend in those knees. walk your hands just kind of one handprint back, maybe a little further. And we're gonna take a thread the needle. Now, if you need more stability and walk more back here, do so, but you're gonna work into a little bit more threading through, taking that right arm to the outside of the left leg, threading through the left. Some stability in the left shoulder, opening across the right scapula, reaching those heels to the mat, just find some stability, breathe in, breathe out. One more breath, maybe allowing the gaze to come underneath the arm. And then let that right hand land and switching sides. Should have done this side first so I could have seen you. And then landing that left hand down, walk those hands back out to that downward dog shape. On an inhale, lift your tippy toes, roll forward to your plank. Lift those hips, exhale, press back, downward dog, lower belly pulls in. And then look to the front of the mat, just begin to walk one foot, then the other, top of your mat. Feet are gonna land hips distance. Drop opposite shoulders, this feels good. Play a little side to side. Letting gravity open up those shoulders and then exhale, let the arms release down. Drop your weight into those heels, curl the tailbone, take a slow roll to stay on it. Shrug the shoulders up and back a couple times. Opening across the front. And then walk your feet together, toe heel those feet together. Take a moment, one hand, so my right hand to my belly, left hand to my heart center. Take a moment, just kind of reconnect, recommit. Feel your feet, feel your heartbeat, feel your breath. Take a collective breath in together, breathe out. Release those hands, open the eyes. Lift the gaze, arms reach up, big stretch. You're gonna bend into those knees, drop your weight into those heels. Lower belly pulls in. Toes are light, so knees tractioning over those ankles. Lengthen your tailbone and then charge up the legs, rise up straight and then bend those elbows down the back. Little lift through the collarbone. And find that again, inhale. Exhale. More like that, breath in, and out, spinning the thighs in. Last one, breath in, reach, feel that spine long, exhale, fold. Inhale, find your length, find space. Step one foot back on the other, find plank pose. Your knees could certainly come down, modify, totally fine here. Find that shift forward. Lower all the way to your belly. Untuck the toes, breath in, finding three cobra rolls here. So go into medium high, nothing forced. You need to be in cat cow, be in cat cow. And then pressing through table pose back to your heels. Child's pose always there for you, back to downward facing dog together, exhale. On your next inhale, right leg's gonna lift high to the sky. Open your hip. Just be mindful that that left shoulder doesn't dump down to the earth. Anchor through that left heel and bend that knee, just kind of like what we did before. You're gonna bring it out to the side. Lower belly pulls in, now lift out of the left shoulder. Extend the right leg out and drag it down, down, down. Now, if it doesn't feel good to straighten the leg, don't worry about it. Inhale, lift up. Bend the knee, find that fire hydrant. Bring the knees slightly forward into the hip flexor and then maybe extend out and down. One more, inhale, feel that rotation. Drag it down slowly. This time, kick the leg straight back. Look forward, draw the right knee into the chest. And you're gonna just kind of lightly tap or hover that right knee between your thumbs. Inhale, lift knee to nose or into the belly and tap. One more, inhale, you got it. And then allow that space to help you step that right foot forward, top of the mat. Right knee right over that ankle, let the left knee soften to the earth on the top of your toes. One hand a thigh, then the other, or you can certainly stay right here. You can also take those blocks and help bring the earth to you. So here, feeling that left hip flexor open, roll the shoulders up and back, and if it's accessible, I'm slightly just pressing onto the thigh, not crunching the lower back, but inner thigh is kind of helping me to lift, bringing that opening across the chest, opening across that left hip flexor. Once again, not dumping the lower back, but I'm lifting up through the shoulders, and those are what are dropping back. Ah, and then now, let yourself soften back in. From here, tuck your back toes, lift the back knee. Using blocks or hands to maybe at the floor or, I'm having a loss for words this morning, chair or a table or whatever works for you, lifting into a supported warrior three. So the idea of a supported warrior three, shoulders right over those wrists on blocks, allows some energy into the legs, but we're not dumping into the shoulders. Should feel some core activated. But it's exactly that, find some support. Feel that right hip crease lengthen back. Left hip in line with the right, so we're not opening the left. Little soft bend in the right knee if you need to. Flex the left toes. Neck is long here, gaze just slightly down. Breathe in, breathe out. Hang in there, feel the lower belly pull in. Give yourself some support right here. Last breath. You're gonna bend your right knee and kind of bring your left knee in behind and let the toes slightly come to the earth. So from here, walk your hands in so that you can start to lift your chest. And this might be where you stay, or you find a little balance of that left foot off the earth, firing up that right glute, right hamstring, right quad, weights into the heel. I'm gonna take my arms and kind of lift them up in front of me with blocks or not, and find a little extension forward, a little strength building here. Last one. Exhale, tap the blocks down. Extend your left leg out, feet find some space, take up some space, big step back, low lunge. Ah, hands to the earth, right leg sweeps back, big stretch. Exhale, 2 feet to the mat. Take a breath in together. Breathe it out together. Inhale, roll forward to your high plank. Knees or no knees, either halfway, all the way. You can always press back, downward dog, or find cat-cow. And then back, downward dog. Big breath in. Big breath out. And just notice, right side, left side. How's it feeling? How we doing? On an inhale, left leg sweeps high to the side, open that hip, lifting out of that right shoulder. Draw that left knee slightly forward, kick the leg out if you choose, and then slightly drag that left leg down to meet the right, covering. You'll find that again, inhale, lift, open, knee slightly forward. Maybe you stay here with the knee bent as you bring it in, or you extend out and slowly drag down. You do you. One more. Where's your breath? Inhale, kick it behind you, breath. Exhale, shift forward, knee into chest. Now, right knee could always come down as you hover that left knee between the thumbs. Inhale, lift, curl it in, and tap. Last one. Inhale, lift, big step forward, left foot, left thumb. Slide that right leg back, soften the knee to the earth, and pause. And just notice, hey, do I need to stay here? Or does it feel good to explore coming to here? Inner thighs drawn in, press through that left foot to kind of lift out of the lower back, dropping the shoulders back, kind of pressing against the hands, one hand against another, against the thigh. If that feels good, do it. Feel your breath, feel that right hip flexor opening up one more. You didn't do this last time, might feel good to stretch those arms up. Exhale, flip the hands to the earth. Tuck the back toes, lift the back knee. We're finding a little supported warrior three. Scooch back just a little bit with this one. So from here, walk those hands forward using blocks if you choose. We're working a little bit more. Once again, in this one, I want to find the support of those blocks or hands. Spin the right thigh in, flex the right toes, lengthen that left leg back. Little soft bend in that left knee, lower belly pulling in. Breathe in, breathe out, you got this. And notice where your gaze is. So draw the gaze kind of slightly straight down, excuse me. Chin into chest, so your neck really lengthens versus crunching one direction or the other. One more breath. And then draw that right knee into the behind the left. Bend a little deeper into that left leg and bring the right toes down to the earth. Kind of walk your hands back. Kind of stay right here. Weight's more heavy into that left leg. Maybe I find a little balance, lifting the right toes. Draw the shoulder blades down the back. Inhale, lift the arms with blocks or no. Exhale down. Inhale. Woo. A little bit of a balance challenge there. One more. Beautiful. Exhale, hands down. Woo. Kick that leg back. Free up some space. Exhale, step the toes back. Hands to the earth. Left leg to the sky, three-legged. And exhale, 2 feet to the earth. On an inhale, roll forward plank. Flow through or downward facing dog, child's pose too. And exhale, press back. On an inhale, roll forward to your high plank. I'm gonna switch sides here for a moment. And then you're gonna lower your right forearm and then the left here to a forearm plank. You modify knees down. Notice they're back at a diagonal versus being right up here like this in table. And then from here, play with lifting that right foot for a moment. And then from here, you're gonna kind of spin to the instep of the left foot, bringing the right knee in. So we're in a little forearm, side forearm, and I'm gonna rotate my right forearm so fingertips face the side elbow underneath the shoulder. Left fingertips stay right here, or you balance. Hip down, and then press down and lift. Ooh, two more, hang in there. As you lift, left fingertips down, come back to your forearm plank, but this time, seeking to find that combo. Fingertips in line with the right elbow, hugging the left elbow in, palm down, press in, lift up. One hand walks in, then the other. You're back in plank, and then three-legged down dog, right leg to sky. Exhale, draw the right knee to chest. Big step forward, right foot, right thumb. And take a pause. Just pause. And breathe. On an inhale, start to charge up the legs, so widen your stance if you need to. Lifting up one hand to hip, then the other. Stacking shoulders over hips. And then straightening the front leg just a little bit. Scissor those thighs in, left hip bone forward. Right hip crease back, straighten that back leg. You can always lower the back knee all the way to the earth and pad the knee if that feels better. Left arm to sky. Right arm reaches down beside me. And then I'm gonna bend my left elbow and reach my fingertips down the back. And then I'm gonna bend my right elbow, reach my knuckles towards my back, fingertips reach up. We're not going into full gomukhasana here. And then I'm gonna stretch those arms out into a T. Draw the shoulders down the back, right arm lifts. Same positioning, reach to fingertips, don't force it. Arms reach into a T. Last one, left arm up, reach. This time arm reaches up, left arm reaches forward. Now stay right here, if you shouldn't be twisting, you can open to the left side to twist. Otherwise, left arm stays here, right hand to right hip crease, maybe adding the right arm back. And you can have a little buoyancy here. Once again, modify knee down perfectly right here. See if you can work the shoulders more over the hips. And once again, you could be open. You could just be forward. You can keep that right hand here. And the back knee could also be down. It's all about doing you, right? Take care of you. Breathe in, breathe out. Where can you breathe freely? One more breath, really anchor through that back heel. And then circle that right arm down, joining the left arm overhead. Ah. From here, you're gonna step off the back foot. Left knee lifts hip height, or the toes could stay right here. We're gonna come into a little figure four, left foot to right thigh. So if you can't quite get it up onto the thigh, the shin bone works too. You can also find tree pose if that feels better. Hands to those hip creases. Start to hinge forward, reaching your booty back. Weight into the heel. You can use a wall or blocks, or not blocks rather, but a chair or a table here for balance. Let your right toes be light. Shoulders away from here. So kind of roll up and back. Maybe adding those arms slightly back. Might feel all right. You want to take this a little further into a standing split. Fingertips can start to come to the floor. You can keep your figure four or free the leg and sweep the leg to the sky. Just make sure the foot, if you're in figure four, hasn't slid down the leg. Breathe in, breathe out. And then re-bend, fingertips to the air, and start to lift back up, free your leg. Ooh. And big step back, low lunge. Spin the back heel down, heel to heel alignment here, sweep or hug the right glute in. If you have a block, bring your hand to the inside of your right foot with a block here. And then you can take that left arm to sky. Now, if this feels better for you, forearm to thigh, do that. You can also take any height with that block. Once again, work with what feels right for you. If it feels better to take that top arm up over your ear, do so. Think about really reaching through the outer edge of that back heel, hugging the right glute in. Opening across that left side body. And staying lifted out of that right, so we're not crunching into that space too much. One more breath. Now, bring your top arm back up. Start to straighten that front leg. Coming into triangle here, a little different transition here. Knuckles to the inside of that right leg. Left arm stacking over. Once again, keep hugging that right glute in. Top arm maybe stays here. Doesn't have to lift. Gaze could stay down if that feels more supportive to your neck. Relax the toes, feel lifting out of that space so you're not crunching that right side body. One more breath. And then take that top arm, let it circle you down. Spin off the back heel, low lunge. Plant your palms, right leg picks up. Bring that foot to thigh, little figure four, downward dog. Shake it out. You can always be foot to the shin bone. And then exhale, the right foot next to left. Pedal the feet out. And then inhale, roll forward to your plank. Journey as you like to the earth or back to downward dog or child. Breath in. And breath out. Shake it out. Breathe in, breathe out. Now on an inhale, roll forward to your high plank. Lower one forearm and then the other. Lift the forearm, elbows right underneath the shoulders. Knees down if you need to. Make sure the hips aren't high or dipping down here. And play with kind of lifting off of the left toes. You can always just let the top of the foot come to the earth versus lifting all the way. Now from here, We're gonna draw the knee in, spin to the instep of the right foot, left elbow underneath shoulder, a little side forearm plank. You can modify knee down, totally fine. Now from here, little lift up and down. You can also bring that hand down here. Lift and lower, hang in there. Just one more time. Not easy. Transition back. Ooh. Hugging that right elbow in. See if you can lift both forearms. There we go. Back to your downward dog, sweep the left leg high. Funky little transition there, good work. Draw the left knee in, big step forward, left foot, left thumb. Now notice your stance here. If you had trouble, it kind of wobbled a little on the other side, no big deal. But just widen your stance so you're on two train tracks versus a tightrope. Lifting one hand as high as the other. Scissoring those thighs, lifting up, settling into the legs, the hips as you reach through that back heel. Right arm reaches up. Left arm reaches towards the earth. Bend those elbows, reach fingertips towards one another. Don't force it. Inhale. Spread those wings to the sides and switch. Left arm up. And opposite. Move with breath. Last one. Maybe you get a little closer. Don't sweat it. Arm reaches up this time, right arm forward. Maybe stay right there. Add a little twist, left hand to left hip crease. Left shoulder drawing back. Once again, you can be more open in a twist, open twist like this, if that feels better for your body today. Or you add that left arm opening to the side. Now I'm gonna lift just a little bit out of the hips here to the tippy toe of that right foot, and then without letting that right knee really bend a lot, not locking it out, drop a little deeper into that stretch. Stabilize through the back leg and the front. Breathe in, breathe out. Upper chest, opening to the sidewall, belly button, stay forward. Breathe in, breathe out. One more breath. Let the left arm circle down. Arm reaches up. Joins the other. Stepping off the back foot, figure four, your variation. Maybe toes to the earth, foot to shin, foot to thigh. Hinging forward, moving back. Find your breath. I was just looking out the window right now. I have about 4 or 5 monarch butterflies enjoying my flowers outside. It's quite a sight to see. Got a little distracted off the window than that. Well worth the distraction. Couple more here. Maybe hinging a little forward, maybe adding those wings. Now, if you want to find that figure four standing split, take your hand to your foot, slide a little further up the leg. Start to straighten the left leg as you fold forward. Otherwise, free the right leg and sweep it to the sky as you fold over the leg. You kind of hold on to that foot if you choose. And then you'll start to kind of bend into that left knee, fully rise up. Ooh, and take your time, right knee draws in. Big step back, low lunge. Spin the back heel down, grab your block if you're using one hand to the inside of the foot. Really wide stance, heel to heel alignment. Hugging the left glute in, reaching my arm by my ear, or maybe just right here, or hand to hip. Really anchoring through the outer edge of that right foot. Getting a little deeper into that front knee if I choose. Certainly be right here, totally fine. Rotating my chest open, thigh opening. Hang in there, breathe in, breathe out. These moments sometimes that get challenging. Huh. What's our reaction or how do we respond? Notice it right here. You can respond with a little softness, ease. Compassion, not running away from it. One more breath, hang in there. And then start to straighten that front leg. Ooh, breathe into it. Arm can come overhead, leaning into your triangle pose. So once again, kind of shimmying those hips, hugging the left glute in, crown of the head reaching straight forward. Maybe that top arm coming overhead, shoulders away from ear. Maybe hand to hip. And don't feel like you've got to touch the floor here. Notice what's happening. happening to that left side body? Are you opening left and right equally here? Are you honoring your body here? Do that. One more breath. That top arm, circle it up and over. Spin off the back heel. Whew. Bring that front foot. Left foot sweeps back. You're gonna bring it to that right foot to thigh, that figure four, downward dog. Shake it out. And then both feet to earth. Little pedal, right to left. On an inhale, roll forward plank. Flow through, downward dog, you choose. Breath in. Breath out. Full sip of breath here. Full sip of breath out together. We're gonna land into half pigeon here. So if you know figure four on the back or seated feels better to your body, then do so. Right knee, otherwise it's gonna come a little bit off to the side. Tuck the back toes, slide that left leg back so your hip lowers to the earth. Got a lot of space between you and the floor and that's right glute. Take a pillow, a block there. Untuck the left toes. Just scissor those thighs in again to kind of lift up and then settle into the hips. And then maybe start to walk one form, then the other forward. You can certainly stay lifted. If you get low enough and you want to try it on, bringing the block any height underneath the forehead and just letting your head soften to the mat, soften below you. And see if you can kind of find this equality of you're not leaning too far to that right glute. You're not dumping to that left hip bone too much. Feel that right hip crease draw back, left hip bone reaching forward. Breathe in, breathe out. Allowing, if you have the block underneath you, allow it to support you here. You know, blocks can have oftentimes very negative connotation, and can we find as we're like, oh, well, it's making things easier, but rather maybe shifting that perspective that it's actually helping us, supporting us, maybe opening a little bit more space for us. Classes I used to call these, I would do a lot of core work with them, rectangle of strength. And an old teacher called it rectangle of hope. So, what's your rectangle of strength in your life right now? Couple more breaths here. Here, your next inhale, lifting up. If you're in figure four, switching that opposite side, I'm going to come over to my right hip and just kind of swing my left leg around. Left shin bone to parallel to the front of the mat and then switch sides. But you come into it however it feels best for you. Once again, kind of feeling that right hip bone to the front, left hip crease back, settling the hips, untucking the toes. And then settling into the shape how it's best for you. You get low enough and you want to bring your arms underneath, like creating a pillow for your forehead or using that block. What you need right here, you do that to yourself. Thank you. slowly lift up. Come over to that left hip. We're going to open into a wide straddle facing the side. Add your ankles, your legs, your hips, however you need to. I'm going to kind of just let one move the muscle away from one cheek and the other. And if you need to kind of bend those knees to find length of the torso, then do so. Toes to the sky, knees to the sky. And then you can take it a little further if you choose, walking one hand forward than the other. Just make sure that feet and knees haven't dropped forward in towards the earth. Really anchor through your sit bones here. This is that assist I always like to do where I would help you spin your thighs behind you so that they externally rotate to root down to help you lengthen forward. See if you can do a little bit of that for yourself. Keeping the chest open, so shoulders drawing down the back, so we're not caving, rounding forward, creating tension in the neck. Knocking at your own door. Always looking for something. You send some appreciation and gratitude to your body right now for showing up, for those parts that feel strong, the parts that maybe felt a little bit weaker today or were tight, less open. Love, appreciation, gratitude to all parts of you. You just gotta let that good river flow into. And then with your next inhale, no rush, rise back up. Hands behind those legs, draw those knees together. Feet to the earth, hands behind you, just a little drop side to side. And then coming back around, facing the front if you turn to the side like I did. And if you do have that block or maybe a bulk or something, bring it beside you, no rub, no worries if you don't. Just take your time rolling down to your back. Walk the feet in close to the fingertips. So feet right underneath the knees here at distance. Fingertips just barely touching the heels is a good judge. Have your shoulders under one and the other. Begin to kind of tilt the pelvis and then lift one hip and the other, not one hip, one vertebrae than the other. Lift your hips to the sky. Keep your gaze straight up, so don't turn to me. And then make sure those knees aren't splaying out, so create some energy inward, spinning those thighs in. Now, if you have that block close by and you want to give it a try, take that block to your sacrum here, any height. Bring your forearms down and just let your body allow some support here. You know, sometimes we're programmed, so to speak, to do the hardest thing or the hardest way, but maybe we can find a little bit more from finding that most supportive way, most nurturing way for ourselves. You can stay right here or straighten one leg, getting into a little psoas stretch for both legs at the same time. Widening those feet out. Once again, you could just be one knee bent, the other leg straight. No tension in the lower back if you do this. You should feel some nice opening across right here, deepen the psoas and hip flexors. You want to add those arms overhead. Breathe in, breathe out. Lifted the arms overhead, just gently bring them in beside you. If you extended legs, make sure that you evenly do both sides, so walk them back in. Tilt the pelvis just a little bit. Place those hips back on the block. And then you're gonna lift off of the block for a moment, arms beside you, just find a little strength and fire in the legs. Maybe interlacing those fingers. thighs spinning in, pressing hips up. Collarbone moving towards your chin, opening there. Once again, you can stay to your block. And then release the interlace. Untuck one shoulder than the other. Take a slow roll down. Can you feel each vertebra connecting back to the earth? Let your knees drop towards one another. Feet walk to the edges of the mat. Just gently press inward, releasing the lower back. And then if it feels good for you, finding that reverse, soles of the feet together, knees opening out. One hand to belly, one to your heart. Just close the eyes and take a moment to pause. Feel your breath, feel your body again. Feel your heartbeat. Appreciate the pause, space between. Hands come into the outfit of the knees. Gently draw the knees together into the chest and squeeze a rock, whatever feels good. And any other movement that might feel good for you before you find your final space, please take it. We are running, I think we started a little late, but we'll run over just a little bit. So just be aware of that. If you do need to go, make sure you have time for some stillness before you kind of move off into the busyness of your day. Grant yourself this time. So when you start to land into this final space of stillness, you take a big sip of breath, breathe in. Open the mouth, side out, feel the shoulders soften, feel the body just drop down, down, down. Closing the eyes, letting the breath just land on its own. Allow yourself to be right here, right now. Thank you. start to connect back to your breath. Deeper inhale, exhale, letting that energy run through you. Wiggling the toes, the fingers. Maybe giving yourself a big stretch as if you just woke up. An amazing rest. Drawing the knees into the chest, give yourself a big squeeze in gratitude for this time, your body, this practice. And then make your way over to your right side. Just take a moment to pause and collect what you will take with you as you roll up your mat and what you can leave behind that no longer needs to be in your space. In the head heavy, eyes gently closed, lifting yourself back up as we finish this practice together. Just bringing those palms together, heart center. One final deep breath in together. Deep breath out. And lifting those thumb knuckles up to your third eye center point, we close this practice together. Honoring the sweet light within us. Bowing together, giving thanks to ourselves, one another in this beautiful practice, and together saying, Namaste. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I hope this practice served you well, your body, your heart, your mind. Take it with you today. I'll stick around if you have any questions. I'll send out the recording afterwards as well. Have a beautiful, beautiful day.
Thank you so much. That was awesome.
Good. Thank you.